up, you guys? What a do? Welcome back to the channel. As you guys can tell from the title, today we are doing my annual summer recap. I did one of these videos last year and I thought it'd be fun to keep the tradition alive. And yeah, I like to do these videos because they're kind of like a diary entry or like a journal entry. That's how I treat a lot of my YouTube videos, is kind of like a diary entry where I can just look back on them over the years and see what I was doing at that time in my life. So it is officially the middle of September. We are getting cooler days. Sweatshirts are getting on. We have been having like low 70s, even sometimes like low 60s here in Colorado, and it's been amazing. So it's definitely time for me to do this video. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump on in. First off, I really think of summer. I know summer obviously is like the middle of June to the middle of September, but my mind thinks of it from like Memorial Day to Labor Day. So that's kind of where I'm going to be doing this video. For Memorial Day, I don't really remember doing anything special or anything like worthwhile. My mom's birthday is also usually Memorial Day weekend. Usually I spend some time with her or go visit her, but this year I did not, but we started June out with a surprise date night. My husband planned everything. He just kind of told me, hey, this is when we're going, be ready. That was really fun. I don't recall him doing that ever in our marriage or in our dating relationship. He may have, honestly. I think he has, but I've always like known where we were going because we usually like to go to like the Melting Pot. Yeah, this time though, we went to a place we've never been, which was a little French bistro. It's this really cute, quaint restaurant. We had a whole bunch of really good food, and then I had a really good creme brulee, and it was just a really nice start to the summer. And then a few days after that, I actually traveled out to the East Coast, which was pretty much my highlight of June. I was out there for about a week. Reason I was out there is my family recently moved out there. I have some family that's lived out there for a couple years, but then I had more family that moved out there. So I went to visit them and see their new property that they bought and kind of just hang out with them and experience some of that East Coast lifestyle. There we went to Rehoboth Beach, which I believe is in Delaware. And that was really cool because I don't know, I just always thought beaches up north in like the East Coast side north, you know, were like cold or just didn't really have, you know, when I think of beaches, I think of like Florida. So it was really cool to see the beach there and the boardwalk. We hung out, we went to the water, we hung out at like one of the arcades, and then we got dinner. I think it's like the Purple Parrot, I think is what it was called. Really good vibes. It was the first week of Pride Week, so everybody was out and about and just showing off their pride. Also, while I was out there, I tried Wawa for the first time. Growing up watching YouTube, I always heard of people doing Wawa runs, especially BF versus GF. They would always be like, we're going to Wawa, let's do a Wawa run. So I never experienced Wawa before this trip, and it was pretty cool to see what the hype was about. I tried the like cream cheese bite thingy, I don't remember what it was called, and I got like a coffee from their little coffee barista smoothie bar, and it was just cool to finally like see what the hype was about Wawa. We also went to Pfeiffer Farms or Pfeiffer Orchards, which is in Wyoming, Delaware. It's a really, really pretty orchard that they grow a lot of stuff throughout the seasons. I went there in December of last year when I visited my family out there. This year, of course, since it was summer, they were doing something completely different. So we got to pick blueberries, which was really, really cool. We don't really have stuff like that near me, besides like pumpkin patches in the fall, or trying to think like peaches, Palestine peaches, like over there, you know, to the west. But we don't really have like orchards like that and stuff. So it was really cool to go there, try all that stuff. I think I tried like an apple. Was it apple? I think it was apple, like an apple crisp sundae or something. And then they have a cute little farmer's market that I got a whole bunch of jam from. So I brought those back home and just, it was really cool. We also went to a few other like little markets like that, like Amish markets or like little small roadside markets. And I got some beehive thingies. I got honey. I got some lotions and stuff like that. Speaking of Amish, we actually went up to Lancaster, which is one of the like the most densely populated Amish countries. And the reason we went up there is because I am a huge like history slash genealogy nerd. I really like to like know where my ancestors came from. And so one of our first descendants that came here to America, his name was Matthias. He actually purchased this estate from William Penn. It's called White Chimneys. It's in Lancaster. Lancaster, however you say it. And so we actually went to that building. It's now a wedding chapel, or like a wedding venue. So that was kind of like cut off and private, but we pulled off on the side of the road and I took some pictures and just got to kind of feel that history and, you know, read about all that. As well as we went to a few graveyards to walk up and down and look at the stones, just try to see, you know, if we could find any slave makers. We ended up finding my 16th great grandfather's headstone, which was really, really cool to like just see that history. And I don't know, it was just very like full circle moment. I was there with my grandmother too, so it just felt like a bonding experience, and just kind of got to see our history. While we were there too, we went to, I'm totally gonna blank what it was called, but we went to this cute little quaint market that was like inside this building, and it had everything. It had fresh seafood, fresh food, fresh meats. It had fresh dairy. There was somebody selling mushrooms there. There was somebody, like all types of mushrooms. There was somebody selling like CBD flower and tinctures and stuff like that. And that stuff is like right up my alley. So we got there like right when they were about to close. So we were running up and down the aisles looking for stuff that we were interested in. I also got some tea, honey, lotions, candles, stuff like that. So that was really cool. And then I believe that same day on the way home, we stopped at a fish market or like a seafood market and picked up blue crabs. And that was really cool because blue crabs are like, that's like in the East Coast, they're known for their blue crabs. And so we had a huge blue crab dinner with the family. We like cooked it all, which we're not from the East Coast. And so like trying these new foods or like learning these new cultures, it was just really cool to like experience that with the family. I will say blue crabs, I don't think I'm a huge fan of them, at least like not having to dissect them and everything. If it's already like done or put in like a crab cake, I'm there. But they were a lot of work. We also got them when they were, I believe they were like soft, so they were harder to get all the meat out. I did try the I think it's called like the mustard, and basically it's like the intestines. But a lot of people say it's a delicacy, so I wanted to try it out. And yeah, I'll try everything once, but just once. Like I said in the beginning of this video, I have family that's lived out there for a few years, but some of my family just moved out there in like March. So I was exploring their property. They bought a couple acres, like a few, I think it's like 40 acres or something like that. So we got on the four-wheelers and got to explore the property and see what it was like. We also saw a whole bunch of baby fawn, which they're like so small. I didn't think that they were gonna be that tiny, but like they were so cute and they were like super anxious, and like every time we got near one, it would like dart across the property. But yeah, that was a really fun time too, just to hop on the four-wheelers and go and explore. And yeah, that was pretty much my East Coast trip. It was a lot of fun to hang out with the family. And then when I got back to Colorado a few days later, I went and got stitches, unfortunately, because I got a gash right here. It's actually healed really nicely, so it's not that noticeable, but I'm usually wearing my ring also, so it kind of like really deflects that, but that was not fun. I got 3 stitches in my hand. Luckily, everything healed fine. Everything's good. But that was kind of like a downfall from that June time. Right when I got back, I had to go to the ER and get stitches. So that wasn't fun. Also, getting back to Colorado from Baltimore was an absolute nightmare. If you follow me on TikTok, you already know about it because I posted it when it was happening, when I was stuck in Atlanta. Very upset. So make sure you're following me on TikTok. But then going into July and August, unfortunately, in the beginning of July, we had a pretty devastating loss that we experienced. And it was just, you know, it was a really sad time. July was probably the worst month of this year for me, unfortunately. While I was experiencing that loss also, I lost my job at the same time, which honestly, I think it's a blessing in disguise, because losing that job was like the chapter I needed. needed to close, and the way that I was treated and the way that I saw things, it was time for me to go. It just sucked that while I was already down, I felt like I was getting kicked while I was down. So, Anyways, July was pretty tough the first couple of weeks of July, unfortunately. We did still go and celebrate my husband's birthday, so that was fun. We went to Olive Garden with his family and just all kind of hung out. Did, you know, the Olive Garden soup salad and pasta, and then we got dessert and stuff like that. So I was glad that we still celebrated my husband's birthday, even though we were going through a pretty sad time. He's not the type that like celebrates himself or really like makes his birthdays a big deal or anything. For us to be able to still do that, even though I know he wouldn't care or like didn't care, it still in a way meant a lot. And then towards the end of July, we went on a family trip with his side of the family. We actually went to Florida for a week. So we flew into Miami. We did a red eye flight and we flew into Miami. Also, vlog is up in the iCards if you guys want to see that vlog. But we flew into Miami and hung out for the day, kind of explored. We stayed at the most beautiful Airbnb. Seriously, it was like gorgeous. I think it was called Tropical Hideaway or Tropical Hideout. It was in Kendall, which is just south of Miami. And yeah, we just relaxed the first day, kind of caught up on some sleep. And then the next day, one of the highlights of our trip is we went to the Everglades Gator Farm, which I've never done that. For how many times I've been in Florida, I've never done that. And that was really cool. My in-laws actually upgraded our ticket to like the VIP tour. I don't know what they call it there, but we got to go behind the scenes. We got to hold some baby alligators. We got to hold like a 6-month-old baby alligator. It was like the size of like a salamander. It was so cute. And then we got to hold a 2 to 3 year old alligator and then like a 5 to 6 year old alligator. As well as on that tour, when we were behind the scenes, we got to see an albino alligator, which was really cool. Like that albino alligator, it looked so majestic and so like you don't ever see that type of stuff. So it was really, really cool. We got to feed the pond that has like 300 plus gators in it. We got to feed it some chicken. We went on an airboat tour and just kind of did all the gator farm festivities. And then the next day after that, we actually had kind of a chill day. Again, we went to Miami, went to the beach, kind of walked around the boardwalk, did a little bit of shopping, and just kind of hung out, enjoyed the heat, enjoyed the nice humid hot weather. And then that night we went to sushi because it was actually my husband and I's 1 year wedding anniversary the next day, but we were having a full day of travel because we were going down to Key West the next day. So we went to sushi that night at Sushi Saki, I believe, which it was just okay. I'll be honest, I've had better sushi here in Colorado. But it was nice to still be able to like take a moment to go celebrate our anniversary. So on our way down from Miami to Key West, about halfway through, we stopped at the Turtle Hospital, which was really cool. We went in, learned about all these turtles, got to see a whole bunch of turtles, got to see like how they fix their issues, got to learn about like bubble butt, which is where if they get hit by something, this like the gas underneath their shell gets locked in their shell and it makes them float. Which can cause serious injury or get them to be, you know, hurt or killed more because they're floating on top of the water instead of being down on the seabed. So it was just really cool to see how they fix that or how they treat it. We got to walk around and look at all these little different sized turtles at different points in their lives and, you know, kind of look up close and see what was wrong with them. Some you could see they had like little boat marks. Others would like they got tangled up in lobster traps and stuff like that. So it was just really cool though to experience that and learn all about them. And we even got to get like up and close and feed them. And yeah, that was a fun trip. Then we got down to Key West where the rest of my husband's extended family was at. And we kind of just hung out and chilled for the day. My husband's uncle actually owns a few Airbnbs down there. So we were all staying at his properties, which was really cool because one of the main properties is like the seven most southern house because it's like right next to the big buoy that's the most southern point of the continental United States. And so like literally you look out the Airbnb and you can like see the buoy right there. So that was really cool. And then the following day, I feel like we just kind of hung out and relaxed. I don't really remember, to be honest. I know we went snorkeling one of the days, which was really cool. We drove an hour up the Keys. I don't remember where we went snorkeling, but it was probably the best snorkeling trip of my life. I've been snorkeling in the Caribbean a few times, and then I've done snorkeling in Florida. And this time when we went, we drove out, I want to say like 30 miles somewhere. We just kind of drove out somewhere and then jumped in. And while we were down there, we saw barracudas. We saw a whole bunch of other fish. I don't really remember their names, parrotfish. And then we saw a shark. And I mean, I've seen sharks before, but never while I'm in the water, which was like a little intense, a little scary, because all of a sudden I'm like snorkeling and I look up and there's just a shark like in the rivets of the reef. And I was like, shark, shark. I was all freaking out. But then I remembered there was like 50 of us in the water and what are the odds? Plus it was like down in the reef. It wasn't up where we were all floating and snorkeling, but that was really, really cool to see. And then on the way back to where we got picked up to go out snorkeling, on the way back, we ran into, I'm not sure what they're called, but like a pod of dolphins, which I've never seen dolphins ever in the, like out in the wild. I think I've seen them at the aquarium once or twice, but these dolphins were just like jumping up in the water. There was one of the dolphins that had a cute little, like tiny little fish in its mouth, and it kept throwing it up and like riding the water and catching it and throwing it up and like catching it. It was so cute. And they were just, you know, doing their jumps and their swimming and stuff like that. So that was really cool to see. And then I think that night we went out and kind of just walked around Key West. We went to Smoke and Tuna, which was having a live band that night, so we just got drinks and kind of hung out and relaxed a little bit, caught up with each other, and just, you know, had that family time. While we were also there, like I said, my husband and I were celebrating our 1 year anniversary, and so we decided to do something, just me and him, so we went parasailing. I've been parasailing one other time, probably like 12, 15 years ago, and it was in actually Lake Havasu, Arizona. So I've never parasailed over the ocean, which was really cool to get to experience with my husband. So we, you know, went up on the parasail, and while we were up above the water, we saw another shark, which was really cool. And we just rode around the bay and got a look at all the Keys, and it was just really pretty. So yeah, that was pretty much the Florida trip. It was really nice and relaxing, super chill, good time with family, good time for me to just spend with my extended in-laws and get to learn about them a little bit more. A lot of my husband's family, they're all like, they live everywhere. They live in Texas, they live in the East Coast, they live in Alaska. So it was really nice for us all to be able to get together and just kind of catch up and, you know, spend that time with them. Cause like I said, I don't see them a lot. So unfortunately though, getting home from Miami, we drove back up to Miami to fly out. We had another nightmare getting home. So that is like the overarching theme of traveling this summer, is getting home, getting to my destinations, fine, easy, you know, maybe a little delayed flight here and there, but getting home on these flights this summer was like a nightmare. Of course, we had a nightmare getting home. Eventually, like 18 hours after we were supposed to be home, we got home. And yeah, that was pretty much the end of that trip. And then in August, it was a pretty chill month again. I did start working again. I did start picking up some jobs and some side stuff. So I did some swim lessons, which I used to teach swim lessons in my teenage years. And you know, it's kind of like riding a bike. If you learn how to swim and you teach swim lessons, it's, you just pick it back up. But this time I was able to do private swim lessons, which was really nice because I got to choose the clients I wanted to work with, the children I got to work with, and then like the times and hours and places I wanted to work, which is really nice. And then as well as I started a few childcare jobs, which I'm really excited for. Children and fostering children and just spending time with youth is something I really enjoy. So it's been really nice to be able to get back into that. That was pretty much my summer. It was, you know, two really good trips, and other than that, it was pretty calm and chill. I'm very excited for fall though. Like, fall is definitely my season. I thrive in fall. I just feel like I'm a fall girl. That is my summer 2023 recap. If you guys want to see what I did last year, don't forget to check the iCard or the description down below, as well as my Florida vlog, as well as I did a video kind of like this where I did my thoughts and opinions after being married for a year. So definitely check those videos out. Don't forget to hit subscribe on your way out. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, and I'll see you guys in the next one.